die. We die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. You may take your seat. If you would, why don't somebody just put your hands together and say hallelujah. That was well lived. It was a life that represented that of Christ. It was a life that depicted that of love. It was a life that depicted servanthood. Amen. Somebody. And although this program here doesn't say celebration, we know that that's what this is. This program says in loving memory of. But if y'all knew Louise, you knew that she never turned down the opportunity to have a good time.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
So I want us to make sure that in her last shindig. Have I got it with me? This is her last. And y'all didn't know you was going to get an invitation, but you got one. So since you got dressed and you all cute, you got your makeup on, you got your hair did, you got your smell good on, you may as well come on and help us celebrate. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, somebody. Come on, let's celebrate. Amen. Mixed up. I want us to eventually get it right. What we tend to do is we tend to be happy at the birth of somebody coming into this world, and we cry and fall apart when they leave here. But we should be falling apart when they come because of what they're coming into. We should rejoice when they leave because God said, come on up a little bit higher. Now, she's better off than we are. Amen?
Amen.
She's better off than we are. So we ought to just continue to celebrate, and even after today is over, let's continue to celebrate the life of our own beloved sister Louise. Now, we are going to follow the program, the way the program is written. Amen, somebody?
Amen.
Amen. I've been given instructions, and I'm going to follow them to the T. Ain't that right?
Amen.
Ain't that right? Louise dog. Amen. So we're going to have our scripture reading, our Old and New Testament scripture reading. That's going to be done by our own minister, Callie Jackson. Right after that, we will have a solo by Brother Bob Broom. I almost called him Reverend. Prophesied something here. Amen. And then right after that, we will have Sister Marsha Chapman come with the acknowledgement in that order. Amen.
Amen.
I want y'all to celebrate. Amen. I can break out the last if you want to. Clap your hands. Hey, tell a joke. It's all right. We're celebrating the life of our beloved Sister Louise. Amen.
Amen.
Change where she is from birth to heaven. She has a glorified body. All time is a beauty. You know, nothing. So God is good to her. So.
of the Lord's mercy that we are not seen, because his compassion fails not. They are new every morning. Great is thou faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul. Therefore will I hope in him. The Lord is good unto them that wait for him, for the soul that seeketh him. That's Lamentations 3, verses 22 through 26, Old Testament. New Testament reads as such. It's Romans 8. And Romans 8, we're going to read verses 35 through 39, and they read as such. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. I've read to you Lamentations 3, verses 22 through 26, Romans 8, verses 35 through 39, and the Lord have a blessing for the readers, the hearers, and especially the doers of his holy word.
Amen. Amen.
There is one tribute to my sister Louise. I ask myself, how could this be? Then I looked above the trees. I see your face, and I hear God saying, I got this, so let it be. Because she is free, and may she rest in peace from your sister Gloria above. A heavenly homecoming. We know that God will give each of us a place to live. These homes are in heaven and will last forever. 2 Corinthians 5:1. A tribute to my sister. God made us special, as we all can see. We live with pain and suffering, not knowing when we will be free. When the time comes, it's hard to understand, but always put it in God's hand. Our prayers are with you and the family. Love always, Nora and Roger. Hope you find comfort in knowing that the one you love so much is now perfectly at rest with God. Expressions of gratitude. The family of Louise Francis LeBeau Johnson would like to thank you for the many acts of kindness, loving kindness, shown to us during our bereavement. Your thoughtfulness is deeply appreciated and will always be remembered. Those are the acknowledgments at this time. While I'm here, I would like to say my remarks. Ecclesiastes 3:4 states, there's a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to mourn. Therefore, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. The three things I'd like to share with you about Sister Louise. First, she was a member of the Antioch Missionary Baptist Church Choir for many years. I remember Sister Louise marching down the aisle in her choir robe every Sunday, marching up to Zion, that beautiful city of God. Second, she was a member of the Eastern Star and marched in her white uniform in the Martin Luther King Parade and in the Juneteenth Parade in the city of Long Beach. Now Louise has a new role, new glorified body, resurrected and restored to an immortal body by God Himself. Finally, she was a member of the Antioch Noonday Bible Study and the Black Ministries until her illnesses. On behalf of the Antioch Noonday Bible Study, we are sorry for your loss. She was a woman of great faith, a loving heart, and strong. We mourn with you, and she was a joy to know and a shining example of Christ's love. We will miss her. Thank you, family, for sharing Sister Louise with us. May she rest in heavenly peace.
Amen.
Thank you.
What that truly means is to be absent from the body is to simply say, I'm absent from the troubles that I've gone through all these years. I'm absent from the pain that I've been feeling. I'm absent from these folks that say they do when they really don't. So therefore, if we love her that much, we sit back and say, if God called her, that means that he wanted more for her than what she was getting down here. And with that being said, we all got to go this way, so somebody ought to celebrate her, especially if you want to be celebrated. Now, and we go time.
Turk Street in San Francisco, California. Resolution of respect for Sister Louise Johnson. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not dismay, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Isaiah 41:10. Whereas it has pleased all wise Heavenly Father to call into himself, releasing from suffering and calling into the new and large life, Sister Louise Johnson, mother of Miss Paula Williams. Proverbs 18:24 reads, a man that has friends must show himself friendly. And Sister Louise Johnson presented herself as a friendly woman who always displayed a cheerful spirit. Whereas Sister Louise Johnson was a longtime member of Queen Ada Grand Chapter, along with her fraternal journey, she held membership in CRISPA number 79, Dorda chapter number 40, and Irene Jacobs chapter number 262. Sister Johnson is a longtime member of the Queen Ada Grand Chapter and exhibited true devotion to the Grand Chapter. She was later granted lifetime membership in honor of her community service to the order. Upon reflecting on Sister Johnson's membership, we will remember her for her gorgeous smile along with her welcoming nature. Whereas we acknowledge that the cycle of life be celebrated, her time here on earth. Whereas in the moment of sorrow, we are confident that the Almighty Father has given her peace and comfort, and she has passed into the heavenly home. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy placed in the record of Queen Epic Grand Chapter, Order of the Eastern Star, done this 25th day of September, 2021, in the city of Los Angeles. Sorrowfully submitted, Sister Brenda Radcliffe Graham, Grand Worthy Matron, Honorable Omar H. Scape, 33rd, Grand Patron, Sister Terry Thomas, Grand Secretary. Good morning.
Good morning.
Sister Louise Johnson was a member of Irene Jacobs Chapter number 262, Board of Eastern Star. I have several resolutions, and I won't read them all. I will acknowledge them. However, I will read Irene Jacobs Chapter, and I will read the nurses
because she was our president of that particular unit. She traveled from the Eastern Stars seeing Jesus in Bethlehem of Judea, coming to worship him, all the way through the Roses of Seven Seals, where that is the highest degree that you can have, because that's from the book of Revelation, and many journeys in between that I see that you put into your into her obituary. Irene Jacobs, chapter number 262, Order of Eastern Star, working under Queen Ada Grand Chapter, Order of Eastern Star, working under the Most Worshipful Sons of Light Grand Lodge, AF and AM, Jurisdiction of California, Incorporated. Sister Marian Askew is our worthy matron. Brother Darrell Alexander is our worthy patron. Under, and Sister Martha Broom is your secretary. Be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee wheresoever thou goest. Joshua 1:9. To the family and many friends of Sister Louise Johnson, we the officers and members of Irene Jacobs Chapter Number 262, Order of Eastern Star, would like to extend our assistance and deepest heartfelt sympathy and join with you in your mourning after this great loss. You are in our thoughts, our hearts, and our prayers. Whereas on Tuesday, September 7, 2021, God in his infinite wisdom saw fit to move from our midst Sister Louise Johnson, who has been a faithful servant here on earth, to come home and continue his good works by his side. Whereas Sister Louise Johnson has gone to be with our Heavenly Father, the Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians 5th chapter 6 through 8, therefore we are always confident and know that as long as we know we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yes, we are of good courage, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. Whereas Sister Louise Johnson has served this great jurisdiction since her early 2000, and on April 6, 2006, she joined Irene Jacobs Chapter Number 262, Order of Eastern Star, under the leadership of Sister Martha Broom, worthy matron, where she worked faithfully until her health failed. Sister Louise Johnson served in many capacities as well as the devoted treasurer for many years. Boy, you couldn't get her to sign a check unless you let her know exactly what it was for. She was the best treasurer that we ever had. Sometimes you had to almost to the door to get the check. Where is it going to? She participated in workshops, parades, annual days, and traveled in and out of state for her local and grant department, always willing to work wherever she was needed. Whereas Sister Louise Johnson worked in the field of charity, serving and feeding the hungry, attending the sick and bereaved, as well as giving of her time and her money. Whereas Sister Louise Johnson was granted lifetime membership in Irene Jacobs Chapter Number 262 in November 2016, and lifetime membership in Queen Ada Grand Chapter in October of 2017 by illustrious Floyd McMillan, 33rd degree, Most Worshipful Grandmaster, Grand Patron. Whereas to her daughter, Paula Williams, to her sons, Arlis George, Eugene George, and Anthony George, her sisters, Catherine Mayer and Stella M. Jones, her brother, Alton LeBeau Jr., her grandchildren, and a host of other family and friends, we want you to know we share in your grief and offer words of encouragement. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart do not depend on your own understanding. Seek his will in all you do, and he will direct your path. Be it resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy be kept in the archives of Irene Jacobs Chapter Number 262, Order of Eastern Star, Long Beach, California. Sorrowfully submitted this 25th day of September, the year of 2021, by the officers and members of Irene Jacobs Chapter. Sister Mary asks you as our worthy patron, and Brother Darrell Alexander, our worthy patron, and attested by Sister Martha, Room Secretary. Ira Cadell Upshaw Nurses Unit Number 6, working under Queen Ada Grand Chapter, and the Most Worshipful Sons of Light Grand Lodge, AF and AM. Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die, and whosoever liveth by believing in me will never die. Believest thou this?" John the 11th chapter 25-26. Resolution of respect. Whereas on September 7th, 2021, the death angels came into our midst and called home our dearly beloved nurse, Louise Johnson. Whereas the passing of nurse Louise Johnson was summoned by God to join him to see the marvels and wonders of heaven. There, her loving and caring family and friends will be waiting for her joyous arrival. Whereas the passing of nurse Louise Johnson is God's way of saying that it is time for her to feel no more pain, just come to him for rest. Nurse Louise Johnson is leaving behind a loving family who will miss her dearly, but they that in our Father's house there is only peace, joy, and happiness. Whereas Nurse Louise Johnson held the position of nurse president from 2013 to 2015. During her time as president, she made many contributions, as well as making our paraphernalia to beautify the unit. Whereas we, the officers and members of our Cordell Upshaw Nurses Unit Number 6, can only offer you in kindness our assistance and deepest heartfelt sympathy and our assurance that God will wipe away all your tears. Be it resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy be kept in the archives of Ira Cordell Upshaw Nurses Unit Number 6, under the auspices of Grace Pugh's Grand Nurses Department, working under Queen Ada Grand Chapter, Order of Eastern Star, working under the Most Worshipful Sons of Light Grand Lodge, AF and AM Jurisdiction of California, Incorporated. Sorrowfully submitted this 25th day of September, 2021, by the officers and members of Ira Cadell Upshaw Nurses Unit Number 6. Nurse Geraldine Reed Lewis is our president. Brother Darrell Alexander is our medical advisor and attested by Nurse Gesna Goins, who is our secretary. And just to acknowledge, we have Lucinda Palace Number 7, where Princess Rita Gaither is our Queen Bathsheba, and Princess Martha Broome is Sister Leah, which is the secretary. Also acknowledging for Bettina Court Number 35, Heroines of Jericho, where Lady Carolyn Underwood Conley is our most ancient matron, and companion Floyd McMillan is our most worthy Joshua, and the officers and members attested by Lady Charlesetta Randolph, our financial secretary. And last but not least, Shamia Court Number 8, Ancient Arabic Order of the Daughters of Sphinx, and it is also submitted by Daughter Charlesetta Randolph, who is the most worthy Grand Matron, Noble Arnie Spears, who is our illustrious patron, and attested by Daughter Lorena Peters, who is the secretary. And we thank you, and we will be giving these to you.
Life that I live speaks for me. said, I'm not gonna try to pronounce her name.
Amen.
I'm just gonna say Becky Williams.
Amen.
Man, I can pronounce that with the first name, I ain't even gonna try. I just wanna make sure I was good with you when we got here. She ain't gonna tell me I messed her name up. She get home, she gonna say, I know you didn't mess my name up. I ain't gonna mess your name up, praise the Lord. So come on in that order, come on, let's have a poem, and then we have our praise dance, amen. And then we will go from there, amen.
Amen.
We'll now have a poem spoken by Michael D. Whitney.
In life, I realized that one day, that one-way journey into the ultimate abode of just must require the well-chosen expectations. And without further worries from the aspects of life's trials and tribulations, till now, from God's creation to the celebration, I have made it home. At this very end, a place of peace and love has unleashed its 12 gates dedicated my moment with joy. With every kid that can, left behind to rewind in their minds the kind moments to be remembered for the days to come. With brass words and gold divine lion indications, I say to you that my spirit, my body, and my soul is now at peace. And from my heart to yours, I ask only that you pray. Pray for on that one day you too will come toward the drums, for you have accomplished your purpose. Oh Lord, allow those to know that my soul has been ready, and I have been instructed to go hand in hand in the assignment of God's messenger. He represents me. Oh Lord, I have been ready. Oh Lord, I have been ready.
Thank you.
Thank you. soul says yes. My soul says yes. My soul says yes. My soul says yes. He's saying there's more than I would.
Come on, hold on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
He's calling you higher. There is more than I require of thee.
Yes,
he
yes.
Said, don't be afraid of men in the faces. Don't be afraid.
Let the enemy know we're banging on Jesus. So if you ain't on the side that's formed by the blood, this ain't a blood crypt thing. This is the blood thing.
Yes, I love it.
Amen. I'm covered by the blood. My strength is from the blood. I got the power through the blood.
Yes.
And I may as well just make sure that since I've been healed by the blood, come on here, somebody. Without the permission from the one who shed the blood. All right, we'll get to that later. They get good to me sometimes. At this moment, we're going to take a moment and we're going to have the obituary reading. I pronounce this name. This is Keisha Williams. Keisha Williams. Matter of fact, Keisha come up here before she leave. I'm going to have her share with me what this other name I couldn't pronounce. She did a good job. But I won't call her my name, so she knows.
Amen.
So my Keisha is coming. Amen. She's going to tell me. I knew that. That's what I come from. She's going to come now and read the obituary. Amen.
Amen.
Amen, Keisha.
Louise was born on January 12, 1937, in New Orleans, Louisiana. Second born child to the late Elton Sr. and Marge LeBeau. Louise graduated from Booker T. Washington High School in New Orleans, Louisiana. In 1977, Louise relocated to Long Beach, California. She worked for Quartermasters in Long Beach for 12 years, where she was a faithful employee until the company decided to downsize. After leaving Quartermasters, in her free time, she enjoyed sewing. She also enjoyed bowling, too.
Yes.
In addition, she truly had an adoration for children, so she started her own daycare. Louise dedicated her life to Christ at an early age. She was a member of Little Zion Missionary Baptist Church in Kenner, Louisiana, under the leadership of Reverend Arthur P. Clay, Sr. When Louise relocated to Long Beach, she became a member of Antioch Missionary Baptist Church under the leadership of Pastor Joe Chaney, Jr., and then Antioch Church of Long Beach under the leadership of Pastor Wayne Chaney, Jr. Louise was a very active member in church and had a great love for the Lord. Sister Louise Johnson was a dedicated and faithful member of various departments of the fraternal order. Sister Louise began her journey in Daughter Chapter Number 40, Order of Eastern Star. On April 4th, 2006, Sister Louise Johnson became a member of Irene Jacobs Chapter Number 262, Order of Eastern Star, where Sister Martha Brewer was the worthy matron and illustrious. Richard Cannon, third degree, was the worthy matron. She continued her journey by joining Ira Cornell Upshaw Nurses Unit Number 6, where she held many positions and then becoming the nurse president. She continued her journey and received the Queen of the South degree in Lucinda Palace Number 7. She then ventured into the Supreme Department by joining the Royal and Exalted degree of the Amaret and held many positions in Wisdom Seekers Number 19. Through loyalty and friendship along life's highway, Sister Louise Johnson advanced to a higher degree of the Herons of Jericho, where she joined Patina Court Number 35. She had many crosses to bear during her travel, and she advanced to the next higher degree, the Lady of Knights Templar, as a soldier in Ladies of the Cross Number 44. As she traveled along, she advanced to another degree, the Ancient Arabia Order, of the Daughters of Sphinx, uniting the Shemiya Court Number 8. Having proved her dedication and love for this order, she became an honored member of the final and last degree, the Rose of the Seven Seals, by joining her final and last house, Syrophoenicia College Number 17, the Rose of Seven Seals. She finished her course and kept her faith until the end, and she will be missed from the Order of Eastern Star to the Rose of Seven Seals. In 1985, Louise married Robert Glenn Johnson, who preceded her death. In addition to her parents, her brother Clarence LeBeau, nephew Roger Singleton Jr., great-nephew Rashid Franklin, and great-great-niece Deanna Johnson also preceded her in death. Louise leaves to cherish her precious memories to her children, Arliss H. George, Eugene George, Paula Williams, Anthony George, Chevette, and stepdaughter Robin Johnson. Grandchildren Keisha Williams, Christopher George Brody, Eugene A. George, Christiana George, and Ryan George. Louise is survived by her siblings, Alton LeBeau Jr., Thelma, Long Beach, California, Catherine Bayard, Long Beach, California, Stella Jones, Elton, Desterham, Louisiana, Gloria LeBeau, Alexandria, Virginia, Elnora Singleton, Roger, Metairie, Louisiana, and a host of relatives and friends. Thank you.
Amen. More accomplishments, amen.
Amen.
More than life speaking for her, amen.
Amen.
Come on here, somebody. Amen, amen. Now listen, we've come to a portion of a program where I have to enforce a rule, amen. I am the rule enforcer today, praise the Lord. Matter of fact, I wouldn't be scared of y'all, but Paula said she got me back. I ain't worried about that. Louise, she was showing stature, but she was a
boy.
Yes.
She instilled that firecracker-ism in my dog. Amen. So mess with me if you want to. So I have to enforce a rule right here because it says remarks, but then people tend to not look at what it says in the parentheses. Parentheses say 2 minutes, and then it says please. We have folk that got a whole lot of more minutes of what they want to say, but it ain't the time to say it because it's only 2 minutes. Amen?
Amen.
So my rule is that you have 2 minutes. But I want you to understand what 2 minutes is. You have 127. Amen? Don't that sound bad with 2 minutes? 120 seconds. Now, I'm going to let you know something. I got a thing here, it's a device, and it's called a cell phone. This cell phone have a device on it called a timer. This timer gets close to 2 minutes, I'm gonna stand up. If this timer get to 2 minutes, it's gonna make a noise. And if and when the timer makes a noise, I am gonna politely put my arm around your shoulder. Then I will become the escort that helps you back to the school. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I've been given a job, a task to do. And they said, don't be afraid, do it. I got your back. Hey. So I'm coming to tell you, you got 120 seconds.
Amen.
You can't get it all in 120 seconds. Then wait till the repack. You can't get it all out.
Yeah.
Right now, you got 100. Look at your neighbor's neighbor.
Amen.
I got 120 seconds.
20 seconds.
And that's all. And the other thing, listen, I got rule number two. Rule number two is we celebrate Sister Louise. Sister Louise had grown grandbaby. So that means that Jack in the Box time is not now. Y'all know what Jack in the Box is, right? We get everybody up here is going to speak, and as soon as the last person get ready to sit down, somebody pop up. Amen. Jack in the Box is closed today. Unless you're hungry, you got to go next door. But we're not going to today. So if you want to have some words of encouragement or some words, some remarks, then I want you to come. Listen, pay attention. I want you to come, and I want you to line up over here in front of the beautiful picture of Sister Louise, so that she can whisper in your ear while you're standing there that you only got 120 seconds. So come on. Because when you get there, after the last person gets there, we're going to do what they call, we're going to shut it down. We're going to do it with dear. We're going to clank, clank. Amen.
There you go. There you go.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Oh, bless the Lord.
Amen. So all of those that are coming. Now, this is not something that I'm saying to family, the immediate family, I don't want to be whooping by the immediate family.
I get it.
So the immediate family, I get it. But if you're not immediate family, how long you got?
2 minutes.
120 seconds.
And listen, I don't want you getting up here telling me that you her cousin, you from the cousin's side, back down yonder. That ain't gonna work. Here's the family right here.
I'm the other daughter.
Okay, other daughter, you got 120 seconds. Amen. Amen. Hold on a minute.
for me. Say 2 minutes. 100. Come on. Your time starts as soon as you go.
Away about 2 years ago, and she was there. And I talked to myself this morning. I told Paula I wasn't going to show, but my mama would have been here. So I had to come and tell how great of a woman she was. She was a queen. And I loved her dearly. And I took to her. She was sharp as a statue, but like the pastor said, she was a fly guy. And she didn't take no stuff.
No.
she didn't hold nothing.
No.
she spoke her piece. She spoke what she had on her mind, and she was sharp about it. You know, and she was a beautiful person, loving and kind. She didn't do things out of spite. She wasn't evil. She wasn't evil at all. She was a beautiful person. She taught me a lot, and if she just would have hung around just a little while longer, I would have been drawing your instant stuff. She gave me an application. Over and above the call of duty. She corrected me, she checked me, and dad me. That's what I loved about her. I respected her highly. It was her inner peace, her spirit. See, I'm kind of scared of her. See, what's in the middle? See, this is just a shell. She spoke from her spirit. And I loved her. And I just needed to get up here and say that. You know, because my mama liked her. And my mama socialized with her. My mama didn't socialize.
Mary Tillman told us that don't try to steal her because she's mine.
And she took me to her house and gave me a job when I didn't have no job. My lights was off. She said, I take care of kids. I said, what? So I went to her house over by Burnett School Library. And she took me in the back and she had it closed off. And I met this man that was sitting out there and he was looking really good. He had a good cold beard. His name was Louise. She was introducing me to the children, but I was but I got a chance to hang with the children and learn a lot from her. My first time ever eating a Lunchable or drinking a little squeezy. kids. And Louise gave me a paper that stands good today on my job. She said that I'm qualified to take care of children. So she gave me a paper that had it signed, and now I can do that. I love you, Louise. I will miss going to Vegas and the turnabouts. I'm gonna miss you and Roslyn whispering and talking about me. And I'm gonna miss being that fool you call me. And one, I'm gonna share with you, one time she told me, she said, Cynthia, she looked in my ears and she says, I don't see nothing. But Louise, you looked in my ears, but you should have looked at my heart.
Nobody could argue and fight like those two, and they enjoyed it, and they drove me crazy. Sometimes I say, can y'all just stop fighting to sleep? I gotta do a workshop tomorrow. And they just be at it, and they enjoyed every bit of it. So I'm gonna tell you, getting lost was my thing.
Yep.
They let me get lost, and then they talk about me, and then I threaten to put them out. Now I have a traveling partner right now, and I haven't been looking for one. I think I just need to take a little breather in between. But I'm going to tell you, you couldn't have a better person than Louise or Francis.
Amen.
And
amen.
The Bible said, to be friendly, you have to first show yourself friendly.
Amen.
And that was her and I and my sister and then sometimes Carolyn and a whole bunch of us that did a lot of things we're not going to talk about. Enjoyed it at that time. But thank God, God is in our life and he has taken care of us. So
amen.
It's good.
Yeah.
I'll see you on the other side.
Okay, now look, I might take 30 seconds because you jack in the box.
Man.
second home.
She called me right now.
And I remember growing up. Y'all heard me when I said I'm the other daughter. Y'all don't, I got so many whoopings from Louise. I deserve them. I'm going to be honest, I deserve it. But I got some whoopings from the grave. But they was all done in love. I remember sometimes we would be traveling. You heard Sister Broom say how we traveled. We had a van. And we would pack that van with every and anybody we can in that van. And we'd be traveling. We'd be all over the place. This was the bus driver. And we would go, any and everywhere. Carolyn will tell you. Well, sometimes we had 2-3 cars. We'd be caravanning. But we would go so much, and we did so much. I remember Louise said, look here, gal. You need to set out somewhere. You need to do. And I'd be banging, and then I'd get a whooping. Right?
I would. 120.
And after that, I had my own life's experience. When I came back, Louise showed me so much love. Me and Louise fought. My mama tell you till the day she left me, we fought. She look at me and I'm looking at her. She eat it out of my hand.
Singing about the Lord.
All right.
And I've gotten to the age time where I really know and realize how good God is.
Yes,
Father
yes. God, yes.
And I think about how many loved ones I got on the other side.
Amen.
That I really want to see again. Louise was one of them. I've known Louise for a while. It's been a while. Everybody talked about she was tough, but she was. But me and Louise was like that. She'd come over to the house all the time. And I know we went to New Orleans and she took us over to her sister's house and we enjoyed ourselves. And she missed. I knew her son and her daughter before I knew her. How? And one day soon, Louise.
Yeah.
messages to help us to grow, to be more like him.
Amen.
But when we come to services like this, we find that she's already got her wings. So it's no need to preach to her. And it's no need to preach to you about her.
Right.
Because you've already talked about
her. Right.
So my job is to just encourage you with a word that will help you along the way, because we got to go this way. But it's amazing, because when you sit and you spend time with God and you ask God, how do you encourage the people? What is it that he wants you to say? It's amazing, because he gave me something that he said to call it story time. He said, call it story time. And so if I can for a minute, I want to just have a brief word of prayer. And then I just want to share a little story. Can I do that?
Yes.
Amen. I'm not going to hoop and holler today. I'm not going to get all sweaty. If you want to have all of that, you can come to
the garden party.
Come to the garden. 601 West Rose Grand City, Compton, California. Or if you like early services, you can come see us in LA at 8 o'clock a.m. Amen. And Grove, you can get all the preaching you want.
Amen.
But today, we want to encourage somebody.
Amen.
With a little story. Is that all right?
Amen.
All right. Amen. Father, speak now. Holy Ghost, have your way. All of you know me in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Sister Louise. Galatians 5:22 says, but the fruits of the Spirit is love, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such things, there is no law. My little story. I would say once upon a time, but I think we're a little older than that. I don't think we have the babies in at least once upon a time. But back in the year of 1937, matter of fact, the exact date was January 12, 1939. There was a young lady by the name of Louise that became a new tenant of the building. In other words, she got a lease to occupy a new building.
All right, all right.
So while she began living in this building and growing in this building, as she got older, she slowly began to realize and understand that her building had to get furnished. So over the years, as she began to grow, you would notice and find out that in her building, she had something called wall-to-wall carpet. But the carpet itself was made out of this priceless material called peace.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.
And each time that she were around Sister Louise, I don't care if she was raised in hell or not, you could experience the peace of God.
Absolutely.
In how she handled her situation.
Yeah.
And how she handled herself. For I need you to know that Sister Louise, and I'm quite sure that you all can attest to this, that she was a very peaceful woman, in spite of what you may think. Amen to her.
Amen.
All of us have sides that some other folk ain't necessarily saw.
Amen.
But that's why they need that side. Amen.
Amen.
The whole her calls her carpet from wall to wall. Wall to wall means what? From the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. She had something that was priceless called peace. So when you wonder how she was able to understand things that we couldn't understand, is because she had the peace that would surpass
all
understanding. Later on in life, she realized that she needed some more furnishing, so she went and got her some end tables. These end tables was made up from a material called gentleness. She was a gentle woman. You all said she cared for people. She cared for children. And I need you to know that usually when we have end tables in our houses, end tables are usually something that we set things on.
Yes, yes.
And when we set things on the end tables usually need to be strong enough to support the weight of whatever it is that's been on. Somebody to catch this.
Oh, come on, man. Come on.
But she had end tables of gentleness,
yes,
simply because some of the pressures that you brought to dump on her table.
Yes.
It had to be strong enough to support it, but it had to be gentle enough to help you deal with it.
Yes.
I wish you had a witness of
that. Right.
So she had this carpet of peace that was made of peace, but then she had these end tables that sat on the peace.
Yes.
All right,
and anything you set on peace will be controlled by the peacemaker. So she put gentleness on top of the peace. So that when you put the pressures of life on the tables, not only do the threads from the peace come up to help ignite the gentleness from the table, but she dealt with you with a gentle nature.
Yes.
So when you left, not only did you leave with the peace of God, not only did you leave with the gentle nature of Louise, but you also felt the love that came from this woman.
Yes.
If you look later on, she went on and she added some more furnishings. She added this thing in there called a couch. And she didn't get this pretty couch that was in Prince's house. She didn't get these couches that cost a whole lot of money because she wasn't concerned with what the couch looked like. She was concerned with what the couch was stuffed with.
Yeah.
And Louise had a couch that was stuffed with love. And I need you to know, in case you want to misappropriate what this love is, I'm not talking about the love between a man and a woman. But I'm talking about the love that comes from God, which is referred to as agape. And when you have something that is stuffed with love, that means that every time you come in contact with that, you feel what? The presence, the peace, the gentleness, and the love.
Come on, preach.
And I need you to know that love is God, because God is love. So not only was her couch stuffed with love, but it was also filled with the Spirit of the living God. What was her couch? Anything that she allowed you to sit in her lap was considered her couch. So when you sat your children to be taken care of, they sat on the cushions of love. When you sat down and you wanted to talk to her about something that ain't had nothing to do with her, you sat on the couch of love, simply because God says that he is love. And if we want to get you to understand who he is, we must first make sure that we are a pure example of love. So we may be looking at it and saying it's a couch, but this particular couch was her heart. Her heart was filled with the love of God, and she didn't have a problem sharing what she was filled with because she wanted someone else to feel what she felt.
Amen.
Have I got a witness?
Yes.
Louise loved everyone that she knew. She loved those that she came in contact with. She loved helping people. And if she was doing something herself and you needed her, she didn't have a problem stopping what she was doing for her to help you get done what you needed to get done. Later on in life, she went after she got her carpet, her end table, she put her couch. Then she put a mirror up. And this mirror was something that would reflect the fruit called meekness. Because if you look at yourself and you can understand the peace of God in you, then it'll keep you humble and meek.
Yes.
Because we have too many puffed up Christians that are claiming that they love the Lord, but they're yet tearing people down with their pride of life. They're tearing people down with their arrogancy. They're tearing their people down. Every time they get an elevation in something, they think they've arrived already. Have I got a witness? If I'm talking about you, just keep looking this way. Don't nobody know I'm speaking about you. Amen. Some of y'all that went from mopping floors to doing fries, and you think that you already there, but you still got a long way to go. What am I trying to say? That with every level does come another devil.
Yes.
But when you can look in the mirror and not see you, but see the presence of God on you and recognize that, then you can continue to walk in meekness. Why? Because what you see in the mirror about yourself is what other people see about you. And if I'm puffed up and arrogant to myself, I can only imagine what I'm is to you. Can I say that? crucify this flesh of mine. Lord, keep me humble. Lord, keep me at a place to where I'm not seeing me, but I'm seeing the glory of God that rests upon me. That when I stand before people in a spirit of meekness, guess what happens? Not only do they look at me and recognize meekness, but they also get a chance to experience my meekness. They also get a chance to experience my meekness. They also get to experience my gentleness and my love. Why? Because it's called the fruit of
the Spirit.
I'm sorry, I'm getting a little happy. So when we find that now she looks at herself, and when she looks at herself, she don't worry about what she looked like, but she worry about what she looks like to God. Because only what you do for Christ. So when I get up, I don't got to put the cutest suit on. I get the most expensive hair. I can have eyelashes out of here. I'm looking over there because my wife will start talking. It don't matter if your attitude ain't right.
That's right. That's it.
And your attitude must be put in place by this thing called meekness.
Yes.
Because the thing is this, you can't go higher if your attitude weighs more than your pride.
Amen.
Or more than your willingness to serve the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen.
Your altitude is determined by your attitude.
Yeah.
And when you can be meek and humble, this is what happens. Doors will open for you that should not have opened in the eyesight of man. Meekness will put you in a place that you don't qualify for. Meekness allows favor to rest upon you like never before. Meekness will make the people that hate you bow down and serve you. Then she went on after she got the mirror home. She added some coasters to her end tables. These coasters was called temperance. Did she get mad? Sure. But she understood what Jesus said.
That's it.
You can allow folks to know I'm human, but don't cuss them out too bad. I got some over here right now looking at me. Y'all got a four-letter vocabulary that's out of this world. They don't include love, Lord, live. Praise God, somebody. But she had to have temperance. Why? Because in this walk of life, what happens is this: we are going to be tested.
Yes.
But when we know how to allow God to work through us, then it may mess with us for a minute. But when the peace of God is activated, he will pull us back down. Because God said, if you hold your peace, then you give him permission to fight your battle. Because I need you to know that some of your battles that you fight, all you need to do is just be quiet. And watch the salvation of the Lord. There are other times where you can just lift your hands and say, hallelujah, and everything that ain't like God's got to get out of your way anyway. Then we look now that Louise came to the place to where she needed to add herself a dining room table. And this dining room table was made up of this precious material called faith. In her building, for if you can recall this, she did not wait for anybody to do anything for her or give her instructions to do anything because she had enough faith to get it done all by herself. In other words, she understood that the Bible says, now faith.
Yes.
It's the substance of things hoped for.
That's
and the evidence of not that of things are not seen.
Yes.
But what she realized that most people didn't realize is this. She knew when to have faith because the Bible told her to have it now. Come on, there, somebody. I want you to catch it. You can't put your faith on layaway and expect for God to move at your time right now. You can't make layaway payments, you're gonna miss some of them anyway, and expect for God to move right now. God is a right now God, so therefore requires you to have a right now faith. And if you can have a right now faith in God and he does not move because of the peace and the gentleness and the temperance, you don't go falling apart because you know he may not come when you want. But my faith said he's going to show
be on time.
I wish I had three more. If you ever watch how Louise, look at this. You said that you talked about her in the obituary. You said she worked for the quartermaster downtown, and she worked for a long time. And when she got taken off of the job, she didn't wait for somebody to give her the idea. She tapped into what God had already put in her spirit. Which was to do what? Love all the babies. And somebody has got to love them to where when they come, they can feel the peace of God. When they come, they can get love on some gentleness. When they come, they can experience what temperance is like. When they come, they can see what a meek and a humble person is. Yeah. But when she began to do this, she didn't wait for nobody. But yet she stepped down on a thing called faith because she understood my now faith. She always had something good brewing in the pot, said she. Don't let it be a pot, but she was stirring some. And she wasn't like some folks. Some folks come to potlucks and they bring all the pots hoping for some luck. She made sure that she put something in the pots so somebody could get lucky to be able to taste, not just the taste, but the goodness that it was prepared in. Because anything that she prepared it with a spirit of love.
Amen.
She made sure that the seasonings
were
used from the heavenly places.
Come on, man.
It wasn't Laurie's seasoning salt, but it was the seasoning salt that came down from heaven. It wasn't the pepper, that the Morton's pepper or whatever kind of pepper y'all use, but she used seasonings from heaven. And the reason why is because sometimes people have never experienced who God is other than by the things that we do and give them.
Amen.
And so when she cooks with love through her pots and pans, and she prays over the food she's cooking for, you don't have to be saved to get filled with the goodness of who God is, but by eating what she prepared through goodness. I wish I had a witness. Some of y'all had some cake and thought it was the best cake on this side of the world. You know why? Because it rolls with the power of love. The reason why the cake tasted so good, the reason why the chicken was fried so well, the reason why the collard greens just seemed to just have the right kind of seasoning, it was because she did it with a spirit. She also understood this, that goodness and mercy.
Yes.
Yeah.
And followed her everywhere she went. So she couldn't help but to be good at what she did, because she understood what she did it through who he is that provided her with goodness. And she wasn't afraid to stand in the center of goodness and not take the credit. Those were her pots and pans, because she was a good woman. She wanted to make sure that she took care of all. Now listen, over the years there was a decline in her health, which allowed for us to see the new piece of furnishings, which was called the bed of long suffering.
Yeah.
We got quiet.
Yeah.
But see, some of y'all remember when she went. And others remembered when she couldn't go. Her attitude still remained the same sound. Because she understood if God sat her down, he didn't leave. He just sat her down, because now her journey that way was gone, and now he sat her down to do something where she was being still. The power of God still remained the same, because her attitude with God still remained the same. You didn't see her moping and complaining and saying, why is God putting this on me? But yet she suffered long. You know why? Because she can flip back in the Bible and she can see when Jesus hung up on the cross with the nails in his hands and the crowns of thorns on his head, nails in his feet. She saw him when he poked him in the side. He sat out there. It was so hot that his skin was beginning to bake. And they're going to give you some sour vinegar. But in the middle of it all, he laid there because he understood that the process had to be done in order for us to have this thing called salvation. And I need you to know that as she lay on the bed, she can look at the picture of Christ laying upon the cross and say, my infirmities don't compare to his infirmities. But because he died for me, I can say hallelujah. and whining and making it seem like, why is this happening to me? I told somebody last night, I said, you're telling me, why me? I said, because God is saying, why not me?
Why not me?
I said, you threw in the towel, but the Holy Ghost threw it back at you. I said, you gave up, and God pulled it down and set you up. He said, listen, until I say it's over,
yes,
you keep moving forward.
Amen.
Change your position.
Yeah.
When she couldn't run no more, she had no problem kneeling.
Yes.
You may have not seen her on her knees, but she knew how to kneel in her spirit.
Yes.
She knew how to kneel in her heart. She knew how to seek God, knowing that no matter what's going on, Lord, though you slay me.
Yes. Yes.
Now,
yes,
we find that she had a her bed. It was covered with a precious thing called a comforter. I'm going to say it again on the top.
Oh, come on.
She had a bed of long suffering, but it was covered with a comforter.
Amen.
She had a bed of pain, but she had
covering.
Yes. Okay.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Okay, I'm gonna help you. In the book of John, Jesus says to the disciples, he says, I'm gonna leave you. But I'm not gonna leave you by yourself.
That's it.
He said, I'm not gonna leave you comfortless.
Yes.
But I'm going to leave you with a comforter.
Yeah.
And I need you to know that when you have the comfort, I'm not talking about the ones you bought from Macy's that you couldn't afford, that you thought about the light bill, so you took it back because it cost more than 2 months of the light bill. But it was cool. It was nice. It was wonderful. But the comforter he's talking about is the comforter that is called the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
The one that came to take his place to allow you to know that he says, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. So therefore, the comforter is the one that comes in. When you don't see no way, I don't know no way, you can look to the left and the comforter say, I got you, don't worry about it. Keep going. The comforter is the one that says, you may be aching and ailing right now, but I will lay my hands of grace upon you. And it may hurt, but you can make it through. Every once in a while, when it gets a little bit cold, you can pull the comforter on, because the comforter lets us know that he'll wrap us in the cradle of his loving arms.
Yes.
When you're cold, when you feel unsafe, he says he'll wrap you up in the cradle of his loving arms. Why? Because a comforter has been put in position to do what? Comfort you.
Yes. That's it.
And when the doctors have said all they can say, and when the friends have said all they can say, then he still comes in and say, baby, I still got you.
Yes.
Because my job is to comfort you
yes.
until my daddy calls for you.
Yes.
Oh, I wish I had a witness.
Yes.
Because we're going to go through hell while we're on this earth.
Yes.
But as long as I got my comfort,
yes.
I can go through, because he says he'll go through it with me.
Yes.
And if I can hold on to his unchanging hand, then I find out that when my name is called, it's easier for me to transition. Why? Because I don't even slide out of here by myself. The comforter still makes sure that my transition.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
So now we get to this place where on September the 7th, the year of 2021, the owner of the building called Louise.
Mm-hmm.
He told Louise, he says, Louise, I'm not giving you an eviction notice, but I'm giving you a notice that it's time to vacate the premises. He looked at her and he says, I see you took good care of this body, of this building, for a good long time. As you know, Louise no longer lives in that building. But what happened is the owner says, now I want you to move up to your deluxe apartment.
All right. Mm-hmm.
In the sky.
Yeah.
Listen, Jesus said, he says, I'm on my way to my Father's house to prepare a place for you. A place that's not made with hands. When he told the disciples, he says, where I go, you can be there. Then he said, in my Father's house many mansions, if it were not so, I would not have told you so.
Uh-huh.
mansion that now Louise is going to occupy. Listen, because it's built, but it ain't ready for her to move all the way in. But she is sitting in the front porch looking and saying, wow. Because she's in a city where the streets are paved with gold. She's in a city where all of her neighbors have the same mindset. She's in the city where she doesn't have to visit the doctor anymore. She's in the city where she doesn't have to worry about bills. She's in the city where she doesn't have to worry about fake folk always coming around acting as if they love her and they really don't. She's in a city right now where every day will be Sunday and Sabbath will have no end. She's waiting to get into the house that's been prepared with her, for her, with many, 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 many rooms. But now listen to this. The good thing is the same love and the same peace and the same temperance and the same long-suffering and all of the goodness that she had in her building down here, it not only was transferred when she got there, but it was bigger there than it ever could have been here, because she practiced it well down here. So when she sends God someone to tell her, well done, my good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. Come on up a little bit higher. I got something for you that man will never be able to hear.
Amen.
That old song says, she'll walk around.
Yes. All day.
Heaven.
Yes.
All day.
Yes.
One of these mornings.
Yes.
It wasn't very long. Y'all look for Louise. She was gone home.
Yes.
She told y'all, she said, look here. The locks ain't been changed. I didn't get kicked out. I moved peacefully because I understood that I lived here as long as I could live here. God lent me my building. Now he's ready to give me ownership of my home. And if you ever expect to own your home in heaven, you need to take better care of the building that you live in right now. If your carpet is raggedy, you don't get these in heaven. Because there's some mark, carpet people in heaven that's ready to come down and get you right. Switch out your end table, switch out your couch, get you some new coasters. Whatever you do, make sure that this house, and y'all got mobile homes. See, y'all missed that one too. Because this house is not stationed in one place.
That's it, come on.
And God says that we're supposed to keep the word within us.
Yes.
So that as we travel, we can share it along the way. Have I got a witness? Because the man at 7-Eleven that's asking you for a dollar don't need the dollar. He needs your meekness. He needs your love. You need to show him God without telling him that God is in you, because the love of God should come from him, because that's what your house should be
first.
Have I got a witness? And even when you leave, they can look at you and say, there's something different about them. The dollar didn't feel the same when they gave it to me, but it felt energized. Louise, I can only hear her say this, and I'm finished. I can only hear Louise saying this right here. She says, I fought a good fight. I finished my course. I've kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all of them also that loves his appearing.
Amen.
So she get ready to sit back. Y'all thought her and her brothers were arguing for us a lot. Now they getting ready to argue about who got the most jewels in their crown. Matter of fact, they're gonna probably be asking, how you get that one? We did the same thing. We did the same thing. How you get that one? And now they're already plotting and planning how to get on Martha's nerves when she get there. You know why? Because we never should miss an opportunity to give somebody a chance. Because we don't know. Everybody coming here looking like you, have a relationship with the Lord, but it doesn't mean you do.
You're right.
So we're going to give you an opportunity right now. You may be somebody that says, I need to rededicate my life, or I need to give my life to Christ for the first time. If that's you right now, just raise your hand where you are. Just raise your hand. It's not about putting you up on Front Street. I see you, baby. I see you. It's not about putting you out on Front Street. It's not about trying to embarrass you or anything. I see you, sweet. It is about making sure. Because listen, whether you raise your hand or not, it doesn't have anything to do with me.
Yes.
My job is to make sure that I laid out the platform for you to do.
Yes.
So if I did my job and you don't do yours, that's between you and the Lord. And I would hate for him to look at you and tell you at the time of judgment that I don't know you. So if you raise your hand, just say the simple prayer after me. Say, Father, I'm a sinner who's fallen short of your glory. Forgive me of all of my unrighteousness. Clean me out. Renew in me a good spirit so that I may be able to be filled with your presence and with your power. Lord, come into my heart so I can make you Lord of my life. In Jesus' name. Amen. At this moment, your life has been changed. At this moment, you have been reestablished or established in the kingdom of God as one of his children. Your job now is to get into a place that is teaching the word of God, loving with the love of God, encouraging you, and helping you to find out what your purpose is so that you can do what? Be the mobile home that supplies the things that people in this world need. The church ain't the building. Church are the people. Let your house be furnished with the fruits of the Spirit. And don't be afraid to invite somebody. Amen.
Amen.
We have now these Eastern Star dedication. And then right after that, we have the funeral directors will come and we'll do our final prayer. And be ready to go and get some chicken. I know, Sister Paul, I know some folks sit here talking about, keep talking about, I'm getting hungrier and hungrier. Okay. So we're going to get the viewing down, and then we'll do the chicken right after the viewing. Okay, amen. Follow the directions of the directors so that we can do this expeditiously and in order.
If I walk in a pathway of duty, in my world to the close, I I will rest.
Lord.